welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Today we have a question sent in by Bob. If you have a question for the podcast, please feel free to either leave us a voicemail or drop me a note and we'll get to you on a future podcast. Bob's question is pretty interesting. He said, hey, I received a spreadsheet from someone and they did this cool thing in Excel. I can't figure out how they did it. Basically, they had a column of due dates, and while the original due date had been maybe July 11th, somehow they managed in a single cell to cross out July 11th and put in July 13th. He said, you know, how can you do that? How can you change the format within a cell? Well, let me go down here to a new cell where we have a due date of July 12th, and you'll notice that this is actually text. They're not real dates, so we can actually type a couple of spaces and then type the new due date. So I'll put July 21st in there. And then the trick is we either have to select cells in edit mode or in the formula bar. So I'll go up into the format bar and select the original cells, July 12th. So here I've selected just a few of the characters. I missed there. I held down the shift key and hit the right arrow to select the last character. And then if it's something that's available on the formatting toolbar, we could go ahead and do that. For example, bold, italics, or underline all work. But in this case, we're going to have to go to format cells. That's control 1. And we get a shortened version of the format cells that only lets us change the font. But sure enough, there is a setting there called strikethrough. So we choose strikethrough, and basically then we've added strikethrough to just a certain set of characters within the cell. Great way basically for this where we have due dates that are shifting. You get to show the original date, cross it out, and then add the new date as well. Hey, and another cool thing, if you're a fan of strikethrough, it's usually not on the standard toolbar, but there is a great shortcut key for that. That's control 5. Will let you turn on and off strikethrough, of course, for a whole cell. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.